pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Hey, Chief, can you hear us okay back there? First item on the agenda is the consent agenda. Alderman Wilson.
I move to approve the consent agenda.
Alderman Sarver.
Second.
Second, Alderman Sarver. Any discussion? So, as part of the consent agenda, I've got a nomination for EDC, nominated deletion act of the Economic Development Committee. Clerk, please call roll.
Alderman Atkins.
Aye.
Alderman Sarver.
Aye.
Alderman Wilson.
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt.
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier.
Aye.
5-0.
Motion carries. All in favor of approving the consent agenda, say aye.
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 All opposed, say no. Motion carries. Item four on the agenda is the mayor's report. First thing, we're going to move the November 6th board of alderman meeting to November 5th. Election night, we're going to move the alderman if we don't move the meeting. Meetings and activities on the 20th, we have a blue and red around the dog park with Cynthia, making some grounds there. The 22nd was a chamber barbecue, and the first simple gravel bike race, we had 49 registered. Pretty good turnout, probably going to be back. The 25th was the MU extension event in North Kansas City. Met with Jerry Nolte there, a little bit about the dog park as well, and met with our MU extension folks, one of them that are doing 4-H, and then a few others that are planning to come to do other things. The 26th, I visited the first graders at Eagle Heights as part of their social studies lesson, talked about community leaders. That's all I have to report. Ms. Wagner, do you have any to report?
Just a couple of items beyond those included in your package. As has been posted to social media and distributed information by the Buffalo School District in the city, the school district has made a decision to change the route of the homecoming parade on Friday to avoid Main Street and Streetscape, so they'll come down Commercial, turn on Meadow to Liberty, and then take that to Main and back to Heritage Park, that's what that route will be, so they moved that. This afternoon, Dan and I met with representatives from Ralph Ellis, who was the firm that we're using for our utility rate study. And they put together kind of the initial blush of their rate model that incorporates revenue projections, as well as our projected expenditures over the next several years to develop a rate plan. I don't want to talk numbers at this point because there are a number of changes that we think need to be made and some tweaking, for lack of a better term, of we think there's some numbers included in different places or perhaps double counted, so there's a lot of work that we need to do. We'll meet them with them again next week. But as we bring that forward, we can anticipate pretty significant recommended rate increases. In talking with staff, the last time rates were adjusted, we believe, was in 2013, and that was an increase to sewer rates only. In 2015 or 16, we did do an adjustment in the billing structure, but we have not had increases on a consistent basis for a number of years, and I think we're going to see some sticker shock when we're going to pay for our system enhancements, as well as just continued maintenance. So we'll have more information as that comes along, but one of the things we'll talk about, and Dan and I have indicated to the consultants, is we want to try to look at something that, rather than a steep hike early on, perhaps some leveling and continual increases to get people accustomed to those increases to support our growing infrastructure needs. So I wanted to just let you know we're there. On your desks is a spreadsheet that that I've developed and that I'm continuing to work through with staff to help us. At the retreat, we talked about the whiteboard in my office, and I think a number of you have seen it at different times, that kind of has a list of all of our projects that we're working on, as well as things, future projects. So what I've tried to do to encapsulate here are the capital improvement projects, utility projects, other funded projects, items related to governing by goals, review of policy and miscellaneous items that various staff throughout the organization are working on, and put, particularly on the capital projects, a cost estimate where we are on those costs, and then kind of a timeline as to when we anticipate to have those projects underway. Dark green are currently underway. Light green, we've mapped out when we think we'll begin those projects and where we think those will flow. Yellow indicates some hiccups or issues in the process, and a little bit of a slowdown. And if we had any red, we'd say this was a project that was concerning. Still several holes here that we need to kind of look at. Some are future projects, with a couple of projects that will be outside of this, goes through the end of 2019. It's my anticipation that this will help staff kind of work and know where we are visually on a number of projects, and we'll provide this as an update to you all, probably on a monthly basis. And that is my report.
All right, next item on the agenda is agenda item number 6. Alderman Holbert.
I move to approve bill number 2815-18, taking possession of zoning of 18420 at Highway for the second reading.
Alderman Schiller. Thank you. Any discussion? Yeah, we can see every meeting. All right, clerk, please call.
Alderman Wilson?
No.
Alderman Sarver?
Aye.
Alderman Atkins?
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier?
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt?
Aye.
4-1.
Motion carries, this body will continue to vote.
An ordinance annexing certain adjacent territory to the city of Smithville, Missouri, and classifying the zoning on said property.
Next item is agenda item number 7. Alderman Schiller.
Thank you. I move to approve bill number 2816-18, rezoning the property at 617 South Commercial Street, second reading.
Thank you. Alderman Sarver.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion on this item? Clerk, please call.
Alderman Chevalier.
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt?
Aye.
Alderman Wilson?
No.
Alderman Sarver?
Aye.
Alderman Atkins?
Aye.
4-1.
Motion carries, Ms. Black, please read the bill.
An ordinance changing the zoning classification for districts of certain lands located in the city of Smithville, Missouri.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is item number 8. Alderman Schiller.
Bill number 2817-18, is on the property at 515 South Houston Highway, second reading.
Thank you. Alderman Hurlburt.
I'll second that.
Okay. Any discussion on this item? Clerk, please call.
Alderman Atkins.
Aye.
Alderman Sarver.
Aye.
Alderman Wilson.
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt.
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier.
Aye.
Motion carries, Ms. Black, please read the bill.
An ordinance changing the zoning classification for districts of certain lands located in the city of Smithville, Missouri.
Next item on the agenda is item number 9. Budget amendment. Alderman Chevalier.
Thank you. I move to approve bill number 2818-8, using fiscal year 18, budget amendment, second reading.
Thank you. Alderman Wilson.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion on this item? Clerk, please call.
Alderman Wilson?
Aye.
Alderman Sarver?
Aye.
Alderman Atkins?
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier?
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt?
Aye.
5-0.
Motion carries. Ms. Frymer, please read the bill.
An ordinance amending the fiscal 18 operating budget to add $280,000 total to the expenditure budget.
Thank you. Next item on the agenda is number 10, first reading of the budget. Alderman Wilson.
Motion to approve bill number 2819-18, financial year 19 annual operating budget for first reading by title only.
Second. Discussion? Questions? So we can figure out the budget. It's a session. All right. Clerk, please call roll.
Alderman Hurlburt?
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier?
Aye.
Alderman Atkins?
Aye.
Alderman Sarver?
Aye.
Alderman Wilson?
Aye.
5-1. 5-0, sorry.
All right. Motion carries.
An ordinance adopting the fiscal year 2019 annual operating budget for the city of Smithville, Missouri, and authorizing the expenditures of funds from municipal services.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is item number 11, municipal court.
I move to approve bill number 2820-18, Trees for the Municipal Court for first reading.
Thank you. Alderman Wilson.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? Clerk, please call roll.
Alderman Chevalier.
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt.
Aye.
Alderman Wilson.
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier. Oh, sorry. Jeez. Sarver.
Aye.
Alderman Atkins.
Aye.
5-0.
Motion carries. Fire, please read the bill.
An ordinance electing to have violations of municipal ordinances of the city of Smithville, Missouri, heard and determined by an associate circuit judge of the Circuit Court of Clay County, Missouri, pursuant to section 473.040.1 of the revised Missouri statutes.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is item number 12.
I move to approve bill number 2821-18, clarifying the term of municipal court judge for the first reading.
Thank you. Alderman Chevalier. Okay. Any discussion? Clerk, please call roll.
Alderman Atkins.
Aye.
Alderman Sarver.
Aye.
Alderman Wilson.
Aye.
Alderman Hurlburt?
Aye.
Alderman Chevalier?
Aye.
5-0.
Motion carries. Ms. Frymer, please read the bill.
An ordinance repealing ordinances 110.040, term of office, and 110.050, vacation of office, relating to the office of municipal judge of the city of Smithville, and enacting a new 110.040, vacation of office.
Thank you. Next on the agenda is item number 13.
I motion to approve resolution 638, preliminary plat for Eagleburg subdivision.
Thank you. Alderman Chevalier.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion on this item? All those in favor of approving resolution 633, say aye.
Aye.
Sorry, there's a typo on here, sorry. 638. Say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no.
No.
Thank you. Motion carries. Next is item number 14 on the agenda. LC service line warranty program. Alderman Wilson.
I move to approve resolution 639 endorsing the NLC service line warranty program.
Thank you. Alderman Sarver.
Second.
Thank you. Any discussion? Alderman Chevalier.
Yes, so, sorry, I'm kind of taking notes right now. The only concern I have with this is that, you know, we basically were, the city is endorsing a private company to perform a service, and, you know, we don't really have any control over how that company interacts with its customers or anything like that. And I'm just not
concerns is having the city basically advertising agency with this company. I like the program, I mean, if it was a standalone program, I'd probably sign up for myself, but I do have concerns with the city being the, using city resources to provide the private industry that way.
Sorry, any questions or comments?
I think those are probably valid questions and concerns. The agreement does outline kind of that monopoly. It comes to us from the National League of Cities, a consortium of cities, and so they vetted through that program. But those are valid concerns.
Any other discussion? All those in favor of approving resolution 639, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no.
No.
Count 3-2. Motion carries. Any public comments? Any new business for the floor other than, does anyone have any conflicts with moving the November 16th to November 5th? The November 6th meeting would be moved, it's not on my calendar yet. So November 6th is election day, so I'll put us at a minimum of 4 and possibly less, so moving to Monday night.
To the 5th?
To the 5th. Good, okay. Anything else? Right, with that, I'll entertain a motion to adjourn. Alderman Hubbard?
I move to adjourn.
Alderman Sarver?
Second.
All in favor of adjourn, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say no.